out my element. My the same. Don't need no clout, no fame.
No clout, no clout.
Bought the game. All brand new chain.
Ice,
swear the lane. Call the group the gang.
Gang, gang.
Whip that thing.
Whip it.
This shit give me. Ooh, yeah. Them boys fool you trying to do it. Bring the. Don't want no. They pull up with that. No. It's times three. It's times three. This how it go. Park $1 million at the. We gon' make on eat that until we go.
Eat it up, eat it up.
Rich straight to the top floor.
Top.
More PJs than
PJ.
Rich like water, go to Cabo.
Splash.
Cash in the walls, hollow.
Cash.
Your money too small, micro.
Ooh.
Huncho on the call, gotta.
This is Madden 19. I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. We are moments away from kickoff, and we've got a good one on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Indianapolis Colts. With that, let's get on up to Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. For the Colts, we bring in our broadcasters, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Just a short time ago, smoke from the pyrotechnics filled the dome as the Colts made their way out of the locker room. We're set for football as the Colts get set to match up with Cam Newton and the Carolina Panthers. Up in the booth with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and kickoff straight ahead, CD. What's one thing that you're going to have your eye on?
I think about what the great coaches of the past always said, the key to any ball game. Can you rush theirs and protect yours? Well, in this case, both of these teams get after the quarterbacks. I'm watching the pass rush.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by the NFL's most valuable player from 2015. It's Cam Newton.
And when he's at the top of his game, you see that big smile. That's when you know everything is clicking. That means he's accurate throwing the football. They can't get him down in the run game. And his team is having a whole lot of fun. Because when they score a touchdown, some fan's going to get lucky and get the game ball.
Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. On first down, it's Newton. Steps away to his left. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
Newton on third down. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Every coach we ever talk to says to his team before the game, quick start, guys. Let's get out of the gate fast. How about that? They took his lesson to heart, didn't they?
They did exactly that. A nice diving catch here on the game's opening drive. And Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 41. Newton. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down. Partner, your thoughts on this D-line.
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again. Newton. The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes. Jabal Sheard in there to sack him for a loss of 6.
But enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. A shotgun snap for Newton. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. First time they've hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
Really? Really? Did we just see that? That's a big catch. One-handed, I might add, to pick up a first down.
I was going
to
say, on third down for the defense, it's one thing to give up a reception. You just kind of shake your head on a one-handed catch to pick up the first. So first and 10 now from the 30. This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. And caught left side, Olsen. A very solid gain of 27. Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this and, hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Newton now to throw. And that's going to be caught by Funchess for a Carolina touchdown. Devin Funchess from 3 yards out. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Extra point try, good by Gano. And that makes the score 7-0. That time, a 9-play drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. And then we let out by their quarterback, the very, very talented Andrew Luck.
He navigates, he manipulates, he cycles through progressions with laser-like focus, and he can make any tough throw that you need because he'll stand in the pocket and make it happen.
Luck and the Colts come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now it's Luck. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Doyle. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. That throw good for 4. It's second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, The quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Play action, it's locked. He's going to go for a big play down. And got his man, complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. And that one results in 35 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On first down, it's Locke. Quick hitch, complete. It's Grant. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Off of play action, Locke. Now a hit, and Locke lost the football. It's out. But I believe the Colts were able to fall on this one. They were, and so possession will remain with Indy. So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. From the gun, here's Locke. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. They give him 27 yards on the third down conversion.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play on the football.
The Colts with a first red zone opportunity in the ball game. They've got a first and 10 at the 15.
Hey, check out wide 16.
From the red zone now, Locke. And that is out of the back of the end zone, incomplete. T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. And it's second down. And the starting defense here for the Panthers.
Kaywon Short has really rounded into being one of the best defensive tackles in the NFL. What I really like about his game are his hands. When he gets his hands on an opposing blocker and locks out, he's going to end up winning that battle and either getting to the quarterback or taking down a ball carrier.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A shotgun snap for Locke. Man open right side, it's Rodgers. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and 8.
Hey, I got right 40.
Luck throwing again. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Colts in possession of the football to begin quarter number 2. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And Vinatieri is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
This is Fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Panthers' offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. Room here to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 47. Newton now to throw. And this one complete, right side to Funchess. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And he'll be taken down at the 34. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To throw on second down is Newton. Flush to his right. Powerful running. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Too much. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're gonna throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
They go play action here on first down. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Panthers. Olsen. Greg Olsen. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And man, Charles, talk about singing something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catches, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this, after that throw, his hands will hurt later. Not right now in the moment. He's just feeling good about catching it.
Yeah, a little stinger, but a touchdown. Gano for the extra point. Gano the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drive, 6 plays, 75 yards. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Line of scrimmage. Again, the 25, second and 10.
Check out.
Naeem Hines, his first carry. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Check out. 290. Check out.
From the gun on third down, Locke. It's complete to Graham. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis, and also moved the sticks. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just 1 yard there.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this. Fans, a reminder, I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime previews, so I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
But, you know, writing down your ad-lib.
If you print it, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. And oh, he coughed it up, and it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Getting set to go again here. Cam Newton marches back onto the field. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fill him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense as that fell harmlessly to the ground. Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. They fake the give, Newton. And he comes back with one complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. Now Newton on first down. On the catch, it's Jarius Wright. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. So first and 10 now from the 30. On first down, Newton. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore, 30 yards. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. Gano now to add the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Just a four-play drive that time. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? 7 yards there on the first down screen play. To throw on second down is Locke. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now a first down throw. Locke. Over the middle, complete. That's Doyle. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football.
Still first down.
Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. They will come up on a 1st and 5 following the encroachment penalty. To the air again, Locke. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Jack Doyle that time. And that'll bring up second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Luck now, 13 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10. Throwing again is Luck. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Now they got to get to the line quickly. Again, Luck. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. Out of the gun, Luck. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Captain Mutterlin. He's got a convoy, and he might be gone. The 40, 30, 10, 5. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
Partner, what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well. Yeah, they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. Gano for the extra point. Gano, the extra point. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time as we'll turn it back over to Brandon God.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a really, I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a third and about five.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Throwing his luck. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it, and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. This is taken around the 12. Gets around him. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
And now running right through him. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
We saw it at Stanford. It does not surprise me to see it here in the NFL as well. This is one elusive young man.
He set the NCAA record in 2015, 3,864 all-purpose yards.
Listen, after watching that move, I just called for the trainer. I think I pulled a hammy just watching him.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. Finds a seam inside the 40. And finally brought down at the 31-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. He'll get it to the 23-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
This drive is turning to an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
And a broken tackle could not free him. Taken down right at the 10-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
This is McCaffrey on the give. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he's going to bowl his way in for a Panther score. A great effort there. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Panthers have got it on cruise control.
But without a doubt, all credit's got to go to the runner. Found his way into the end zone, but the defensive guys just not wrapping up well when they try to tackle him.
And that's the thing. You've got to wrap up. A lot of times these days you see guys, they just want to go as hard as they can and throw their body at somebody. That's not old school football, though.
No, old school football is fundamentals. Wrapping up, locking your hands, and trying to get him on the ground.
Extra point try, good by Gadeau. And that will extend this big lead. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And the last play on the drive, the touchdown run from Christian McCaffrey. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
And all the way down to the 29. A big play there on the catch and run. 46 yards.
So what's the old expression that quarterbacks like to use when they decide to throw the football? I'm looking for either a touchdown or a check down. And he took the check down on that play, and it worked almost to perfection.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, 3rd down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
We got 4. Check out. 1, 9, 9.
Throwing on 3rd down. Love. And he comes back with one complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
Brandon, that's a tough guy right there. He knew that was going to happen. In other words, he had to absorb that hit. How about him securing the football, churning the legs a little bit, and gaining what he needed for a 1st down?
Well, that's the deal. On 3rd down, these guys, they know where the sticks are. He obviously knew right there.
And if you want to be a dependable 3rd down receiver, you've got to be willing to absorb those types of hits and make those sort of plays.
Here's Luck. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this 3rd quarter of play. 3 quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Indianapolis. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the 4th quarter. A very one-sided affair.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down.
The best offenses and the ones that win are ones that make adjustments. And right now, I think this team needs to open things up.
The Colts on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third down and 12. They'll run the man. Man, this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making them do it that way, didn't they?
And Vinatieri's kick is good. And that will knock this down to still a very large 29-point deficit. Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's come together for you. The big guys up front have created space. You've run through it. You've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it'll be second down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes that's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26.
Four down.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Panthers on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. From the gun, here's Newton. And he gets it to Funches complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Newton finding Funches for the Panther first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Newton now 14 out of 17, 82%, and it's first and 10. Newton now to throw. Finds a seam inside the 40. Quick slant, caught by Moore. And down to the 27-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy, throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Oh. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 27. Newton to throw. Olsen too much. And the tight end Olsen, right side. 12 more yards there and another first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
Newton will bring him up first and 10, and he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Now a run with McCaffrey. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Here we go. On second down, here's Newton. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. So another score there. And often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Gano the extra point, and the lead will swell by one more. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in 7 plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They were happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Luck now, 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now it's Luck. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. That one for Indianapolis, resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. The 50, it's Luck. Brought in over the middle by Grant. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Luck throwing again, and his throw's going to be incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Here's Luck, and he's got his man, Hilton. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A really good pickup of 28 yards. From the red zone now, Locke. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. He'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll bring up second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. A shotgun snap for Locke. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 7 catches for him now, and this last one, a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
The gun. Here's Locke. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working offensively. On second down, here's Locke. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. Julius Peppers in there to sack him for a loss of 6. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Indy.
I sound